from the City of Industry and Channel 33. It's Marty's Corners Halloween Special. Tonight, join Marty and his guests, spiritual psychic Lillian Gray, Corrine Arkenberg, special effects makeup artist, instructor, and her assistant, Sue Lemout-Lomelli, professional dancer and teacher, Norma Weiss. Back again, our musical guest, Steve Craig. The house band, I'm Lori. It's Friday night, it's 8 o'clock. It's time to party with our host, Marty Shields.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much, and welcome to another edition of Marty's Corner, live from Channel 33 here in Hacienda Heights, and I bid you welcome. It's a Halloween show here on Channel 33, and we're having such a good time here, you can't believe it. We like to, before we start, please bow our heads in a moment of silence for a comrade in arms who has been taken away from us from the talk show wars, Chevy Chase. Could we please have a moment of silence? It's long enough. Channel 11, if you want me to be a host on your show, please give me a call. I'll be glad to take over Chevy's spot. I have no qualms about it. Please give me a call here at Channel 33, and we'd love to have you give us a call and bring all of our people here, the corner band. The audience is great here tonight. Can we hear from the audience, ladies and gentlemen? I'm dressed as an English gentleman, which doesn't mean anything, but I love this thing. Boy, this is great. I can actually take on people and just, oh, this is great. But it's hot as heck. How do I look on camera? Wow, I look pretty svelte, doesn't I? Huh? I think this black does something for me. Actually, I'm on a diet. I'm on the poverty diet. And me and my wife are losing weight, and she's really happy now because when we make love, we actually clear each other now. So that works out real well. We're going to have a great show for you. Let me quickly give you the lineup real quick here on the show. We have on Polynesian dancer Norma Weiss is here tonight. Norma Weiss is here. Spiritual psychic Lillian Gray will be reading my fortune here on Marty's Corner tonight. Lillian Gray is here. We also have Corrine Arkenberg. Arkenberg is here tonight. I got that right. Oh. And of course, making his second appearance on the corner, the singer-songwriter Steve Craig is also here tonight. Before we go any further, I'd like to bring on someone. Like I said, she's going to be on throughout the show. She's a special effects makeup artist at Universal Studios, and she'll be showing us how to get made up for the Halloween weekend, next weekend. Would you please welcome real quick, Corrine Arkenberg. Corrine, come on out, ladies and gentlemen. Come on. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Now, was I right in assuming that in saying that you're a special effects makeup artist?
Yes.
And where do you work? Is that Universal Studios?
Actually, sometimes. I have my own school. I'm an instructor most of the time.
And why don't you go and give a plug to that school right here while we're on the air?
Okay. It's a brand new school. It's a studio of creative makeup art and special effects, and we're in Monrovia.
And what do you do exactly there at the school?
Everything. We make everybody from beauty to monsters.
So and the whole
gamut, everything.
Now, like I said, throughout the show, she's going to be making up. And who's your assistant today you're going to be making up?
My assistant is my soon-to-be daughter-in-law, Sulema Lomelli. She's in the back there. You can't see her right now. But
she'll be out shortly. And what are you going to be making her up for us tonight?
Well, we're going to do a total makeover on her.
Total makeover? Mm-hmm. Now, I've wanted my wife to get into this field because she spends an hour in the bathroom making up already. So I figured we're going to get some money out of this. Money out of this. Wow. 2, 3, money out of this. Oh, sorry. So why don't you go ahead and take off and go that. And people here again for Corrine. She'll be coming on later on the show. And she'll be bringing on her assistant. Again, like I said, we have an incredible show for you tonight. We're going to have the famous top 9 list here tonight. You're going to love this one, you guys. And we're also going to take a little trip down to Francisco's in downtown La Pointe, Main Avenue. And we're going to go to Francisco's and look and see who's got for us here on Halloween weekend. Don't go away. We'll be right back. Like I said, we have everybody on the show tonight. If you're watching us, you're watching us live. Call us 333-2427. Guys, take it away. Welcome to Marty's Corner. Hi, I'm your host, Marty Shields.
Leadoff batter for Highlander B hits a ground ball.
The leading my angel would watch over me.
There's no such thing as killer keys.
Oh!
Hi, how you doing? I'm Kevin the Plumber.
Thank you. We're back here on Marty's Corner, and it's always a love fest here in Marty's Corner. We'd like to go to the top nine that is compiled for us by our home office in Baldwin Park, California. Baldwin Park, huh? Anybody from Baldwin Park? I'm sorry to hear that. We're not from Baldwin Park. We have a picture of the spider. I love this jumping spider real quick. Oh. Okay, enough of that. We're going to go to the top nine list right now. And again, the top nine is compiled by Baldwin Park. And we're going to go to number one. I'm sorry, the top nine list for today is Halloween party tips. Halloween party tips on Marty's Corner. Number nine, no Jeffrey Dahmer finger foods. Number eight, don't ask Marty, what's the smell coming from the crawl space? What's the smell coming from the crawl space, number eight? Sorry, I messed that up.
That was bad.
Number seven, plenty of toilet paper. Every good party has plenty of toilet paper. Number six, dress like Michael Jackson and ask the French maid if she wants to sleep over. Oh.
What does that mean, Martin?
I don't know. You guys take it too serious. Number five, bury party crashers alive.
Yeah.
And I think that's only right. Number four, wait a half hour after Jello shots before bobbing for apples, huh? Does anyone know what a Jello shot is? I didn't know what that was.
What's bobbing for apples?
I have no idea. Number three, invite Marty's Corner audience members to your party, huh?
Yeah.
Greatest audience in the world. Greatest audience in the world. And the number one party tip from Marty's Corner for Halloween is, I'm sorry, number two. Boy, I almost skipped number two. I hope John didn't have a heart attack in the control room. Sorry, John. Number two, grunge is a fashion, not a costume. Oh, it's starting to turn on me now. I guess everybody's going to dress like grunge next weekend. Gunge, I like that better.
Gunge and roast.
Make my own word. And the number one party tip from Marty's Corner is beer, beer, and more beer. More beer. Oh, remember that. Yes. How are you doing today, Lori?
Good.
And what are you dressed like tonight?
I'm a floozy.
Ooh.
gotta get rid of that Girl Scout cookie box image.
Oh, that's right.
Last I don't want to be labeled.
No, I wouldn't be that either. Well, I think you definitely got a nice thing going for
a
you
nice
there.
A nice floozy thing going. Ugh. And what are you?
No idea. We're going to bring on now someone to Marty's Corner who is a person in the community, and she's a spiritual psychic. She takes her job very seriously, and we're glad to have her on. She came here at short notice. Please give a warm welcome to Lillian Gray. Lillian, come on out. Lillian. Welcome, Lillian. Come on up. This is Lori. Have a seat. Thank you, Elaine. Thank you for coming to the show on such short notice. I can't even talk.
My pleasure.
Now, you take this very seriously. How long have you been doing this?
About 28 years now.
And what do you do exactly?
I do the palm reading, the tarot cards, the spiritual reading, and a psychic reading.
Now, I've seen a lot of things on TV lately with the phone-in psychic things, like LaToya Jackson's thing she's been doing. And how much can you actually learn from somebody over the phone just talking? Is that a scam or?
No.
Can you really?
I'd be totally honest with you. I don't deal just by the phone itself. Do you understand me? I'd like to be on a one-to-one with the person.
So do you think?
But there is vibrations that you could pick up from people.
So I would think LaToya would realize that and keep her day job, because I don't think her future is too bright. This is a very anti-Jackson crowd tonight, isn't it? Jeez. Okay, so do you have your tarot cards with you?
Yes, I do.
And what she's going to do, she's going to go ahead and tell my future in just a few moments of time here. And God, I hope it's good. I hope it's nothing bad. Now, how does this work exactly? What's the history behind the tarot cards?
The tarot card is going to tell you your past, present, future, love, marriage, business, answer all your questions.
Yeah, I don't know if I want that much exposed on TV. I'll be on.
Credit rating?
Oh, thank you, Spock. Sure. Here we go.
One more time, please.
Got it.
Your date of birth?
3/14/60.
Ooh, you're right.
Older than means. I thought.
I know, sorry. I shouldn't have said that. Now, how far into it can you actually tell if something's happening?
I'm just going to give you like a light general reading because
all right.
I don't have so much time.
Sure.
It usually takes a half hour for one tarot card reading.
Okay. I'm only splitting it into this. All right.
First thing I see for you, Marty, I see that you're having a very long life to live and many years ahead of you.
That's good.
I see that you are indeed a very good-natured man, a very kind-hearted soul. You have been searching for love, you have been searching for happiness, you have been searching for inner peace. As a younger man, you was a little bit deeply hurt, you was deeply confused over the love life at one point in time. It seems to be there was one woman that you was in love with, but things did not work out for you and her in the right direction. Do you understand me?
Yeah.
And then you went on into working, you went on into trying to do for what you believe in, for what you really want out of life. Mm-hmm. You're a hard worker. If you've got something to say, you're going to say it. If you have something to do, you're going to finish it.
Yes.
You met this other woman that you fell in love with at the same time during working through all of this. Uh-oh. It seems to show to me that you fell in love with her spiritually. And maybe the second or the third time you've met her. Do you understand me?
Yes, exactly.
She fell in love with you also. I see spiritually there's been a bond between you and her. Do you understand me?
Yes. Uh-huh.
And I feel that the love is very strong.
Yes.
And will continue out through in your life. Interesting future. What else I see for you, Marty, through in your business, through in your career, is what you're fighting for, is what you're working for very strongly right now. Within the next year and a half, you are going to move rapidly. Things look a lot better, a lot brighter within the future. Do you understand me?
Yes.
But there was a lot of obstacles over the last past 3 years that you and your wife both overcame.
That is right on. That is exactly right. That is too funny. Yes.
Seriously,
right.
Marty.
You are right.
There is a young person that is in the both of your life that you both love very deeply, very strongly. You're going to be a very proud person of this child, is what I feel. Do you understand me?
Yeah, sure.
But as of right now, there's a few little obstacles. Through in the business, more or less, there's another man that is showing you a lot of obstacles through in your work. I see that you're going to be able to overcome that also. I feel 3 children within the future.
Yes, I have 3 children. That's wild.
Traveling endurance is going to be quite a large thing within your life within the next maybe 7-8 months year.
Wow.
It seems to show to me through in this work that you're in right now, it is going to be through in TV, throughout your lifestyle. But something that you're going to be known to the eye of the public. Do you understand me what I'm telling you?
Yes.
But you've got to be a little bit more stronger within yourself. You've been losing sleep over the last past maybe 3-4 months, I would say. Seriously.
Yeah.
You smile a lot within the face,
no.
But you carry everything inside.
I do.
Do you have any questions, Martin?
now, you've actually predicted my future, and you're talking about my past.
Can you do Lori for us real quick?
Sure.
I love Lori to be done.
How about if I do the palms on Lori?
Yeah, well, you got about three more minutes before we go to break. Why don't you do the palm on Lori real quick?
You don't have no questions?
I'm afraid to ask anymore. You nailed two or three things right on the head. That's incredible. Why are you going to do Lori?
You're right. I'd like you to concentrate on two good wishes, please. Tell me when you're ready.
Ready.
Now whatever I'm going to see for you spiritually, Lori, through in the grace of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I'm going to let you know everything, good and bad, weak and strong. First thing I fulfill for you within your hands, Lori, is that you also have a very long life to live and many, many good years ahead of you. You are indeed a very strong-minded woman. You are indeed a very good-hearted soul. All your life you show to help others. All your life you show to succeed with others in life. Do you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
You extending your hand, you extending your welcome has been very large within your life. Do you understand me? But you the style of woman that when you love full-heartedly. Although when you hurt skin deep. Do you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
There was someone that you fell in love with very deeply. Somebody that you wanted within your life. But I see spiritually, Lori, you and him did not make it, but you're still hoping into something into the future with this man. Do you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to give you a little advice, hon, not to try to hurt you, but I don't want you to hold on no longer. Do you understand me? Because I feel somebody else in the wings that wants to enter your life, somebody else that wants to come forward, that's going to love you like you've never been loved before yet. Do you understand me?
This is personal, isn't it, Marty?
I know, I can.
I'm sweating.
Things have been a little bit hard within the last past 3-4 years. You've been trying to find yourself. You've did a beautiful job in it. Do you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
I feel a great deal of success, but there's a lot of roads to go through. Do you understand me, what I'm telling you? What is your question? What is it that you're searching for at this time?
Peak. What's the answer to life? What's the meaning of life? No, I'm just kidding. What am I searching for? Probably career fulfillment first.
Success within your career is yet to come, but the doors have not opened up completely the way that you want. Do you understand me? But it is in the entertainment field. Do you understand me?
Mm-hmm.
Your blood boils for that. You're very good at that. Do you understand me? Your expectations is very large, is very high. But you're trying to meet different people right now. Do you understand me? But I'm telling you, I don't feel no problem within that. The only problem I fulfill right now is spiritually, sexually, mentally, is through in the love life that I fulfill. There's a lot of loneliness there around your life.
My goodness, I hate to cut Lillian off.
That's okay.
That's absolutely incredible. I wish you could have this done for you. Could you please give a hand to Lillian Gray, ladies and gentlemen?
We're going to go away for a commercial. We'll be right back. Don't go away, guys. Take us away. We are back here at Marty's Corner, and we'd like to go ahead and we forgot we were. I was so transfixed by what Lillian was telling me and Lori. I lost track of time, and we'd like to go ahead and give Lillian a plug and what she does in Roland High. So, can we please get a shot of this, Rich? And this is Lillian's phone number. I'm sorry.
Read it, Marty.
I can't read it from here.
Well, why don't you just look at it?
Oh, good idea. That's what you hear, Frank. 594-1151. 594-1151. I'm sorry, Rich. I'm messing up Rich over here on camera one. Okay, we got that okay? Were you there? Okay.
And please, give us a call down at the station. We'll be glad and give you that tour. We've also brought back Corinne and her assistant, and we'd like to introduce her real quick.
Yes, this is Sulema Lomeli. She's going to be my daughter-in-law very soon.
That's right, we did that before.
Yeah.
And what have you done so far with her?
So far, we've just applied the base, and then over that a powder base and the shading.
Okay. And like I said, she'll be coming on again in about 20 minutes. See how far we go. Why don't you go ahead and take off?
Okay.
I'll let you get out of here and go on that. Ladies and gentlemen, real quick for Corinne Arkenberg. And because it is a Halloween weekend next weekend, we took a little trip this weekend down to Francisco's in the heart of La Pueni. It's on Main Street, and we'd like to show you what's going down at Francisco's. So if John, if you're in the control room, let's go ahead and roll that tape and take it away. We're here at Francisco's in La Pueni Main Street. Francisco Sanchez is the owner and proprietor. And how did this all start for you?
I actually started out taking a chance on Halloween with maybe $1,000 worth of goods and about 7 years ago. And it's gone from that to 8 stores now. So it's kind of grown since, from the beginning.
Sure. Now, do you find that more kids or more adults are coming here to shop?
Well, to me, the adults are the kids. I mean, the adults buy more, spend more than the kids. And if it's a parent with a kid, the ratio is maybe $100 on the parent and $20 on the kid.
Now, do you have certain items that are big sellers, more so this year than other years?
Well, Barney's hot. Batman's still hot.
Is he still hot?
Oh, yeah. Batman last year was the number one. This year, it looks like it'd be Barney, Jasmine, Aladdin,
all the characters.
Ninjas are still moving, but your basics are going to be Barney, Aladdin, Jasmine, that group of characters.
Have you ever had any requests for costumes that you couldn't fulfill, some strange costume requests that you have not been able to fulfill for the customers?
I get all kinds. In this business, you get all kinds.
Do you really?
Yeah, they want to be sea creatures, and yeah, we got a mermaid, but they want to be something like a bass or a trout or.
Now you can't. Now, not only can you buy costumes here, but you also have other decorations. What kind of things can you buy for your house as far as decorations go here at Francisco's?
Something for your backyard. Our buddy Geek. You know, we got
Geek.
We got Geek here, and we've got full arches that you could display a whole garage or.
So you have everything you actually need for a Halloween party. I mean, anything that you
fog
need,
machines,
any need that you want can be found at Francisco's.
Spider webbing, fog machines, Geek, tombstones, coffins, you name
they
it.
They name it, you got it.
We try to have it. If they come late, we don't have it.
Now, God forbid if someone comes in here and they're scared to death, can you perform CPR on them if they actually have a fit?
Depends how pretty she is. Otherwise, I'll send Yolanda over there.
And what's your name?
Samuel.
Samuel, what do you want to be for Halloween?
Well, I bought a costume last year, and my family, we have to, if we buy a costume 1 year, we have to wear it for 2 years, so I guess I'm going to be Batman.
And what's your name?
Myra.
Myra, how old are you, Myra?
10.
Myra, what do you want to be for Halloween?
The bride.
The bride? A bride? The bride of Frankenstein or just a regular bride?
A regular bride.
A regular bride. Do you have a boyfriend that knows about this or is this, he doesn't know that you actually want to be a bride?
No, I don't have a boyfriend.
You don't have a boyfriend?
No.
Would you like to have one?
No.
I have some connections.
No.
Of course, there's Hulk Hogan before he became a human person, George Bush, Dan Quayle, I think. As we go down the line, we have Jerry Seinfeld before he became famous. And next to him is, I guess that's Bill Clinton, although you couldn't tell. And of course, next to Bill is, of course, Hillary on the right there. And that's Hillary's new hairstyle. And she had that cut in Air Force One. And what's your name?
Alex Areola.
Alex, how old are you?
15.
And Alex, what do you want to be for Halloween?
Chucky.
Chucky? You mean from the monster movie Chucky?
Mm-hmm.
And did you buy your costume here at Francisco's?
Yes, I did.
Now, Francisco, my wife would really like to dress up something very scary this year. By any chance, do you have a Sandra Bernhardt costume here at Francisco's?
No, we don't. Geek.
Do you have the quarterback of the Rams, Jim Effert's costume here at Francisco's?
What's he look like?
Well, lately he hasn't looked like too much, actually.
Geek.
Francisco, do you have the Lyle and Eric Menendez costume along with the 12-gauge double-pump shotgun here at Francisco's?
All the accessories, everything needed.
Does that also come with the half-ass alibi?
Sure does.
Fantastic.
Geek, our buddy Geek. You know, we got
Geek.
Yeah, we got Geek here. And
Francisco's not here. What kind of boss is he really?
Oh, God. Okay. That's hard.
Now, is he the kind of guy that comes in and goes, boo, when you're like, you know, when you don't see him and stuff?
Well, he's there.
Has he ever, like, faked a seizure to kind of get a reaction out of you?
No, he does scare you sometimes, you know, with work around, and, you know, he'll say, well, I heard you did this or I heard you that. But, you know, he'll scare you.
Is he mentally stable? You can tell us.
Well, you know, between you and me?
Yeah, just between you and I.
Not really. You know, he goes off sometimes. It's weird.
Now, Francisco's, they not only have costumes for you and I, but for your pets. Now, as you can see here, you can have your pet be, Merlin Magician, a court jester, and the one that me and my wife always like to put on our dog, the Princess St. Bernard. Boy, I think the lady right here is the lady who's next door to me, Mrs. Myers. And she's, I think that's a bad face job gone bad there. I think it's kind of slid on her. We have the famous Blue Mouse. And that was a big favorite in the 50s, the Blue Mouse. For all you people that were born in the 30s, you remember how famous he was. Okay, here we go. We have, of course, the infamous Beavis and Butthead. Cool. And that's really big.
Shut up,
Butthead. And then, of course, next to Beavis is Ren and Stimpy. Stimpy, get away from me, Stimpy. And he's a big hit down here. And the mask right to the left there of Ren is something I like to borrow from me and my wife later on tonight. And we're going to see if Francisco can make some kind of a deal with us. And I'll enjoy it. I don't know if my wife will or not. As we go down, we see some more effects of tooth decay. This is one of the things that Francisco tries to promote here in the shop is proper hygiene. And as you can tell, this gentleman does not. And on the same wavelength, we have Richard Nixon with a $9.95 sticker coming out of his head. I think that's what he was paid off to do some of the speaking engagements recently. As we go down, we have a couple gentlemen who I think, and some of you kids out there, it's really important to wear helmets when you're on your motorcycles, and you can see what happens. This is a print of Gary Busey's head right after his incident down by the beach, and that can't happen to you kids, so please, buckle up, huh? Buckle up. As we go, we have Spuds McKenzie, who I found recently was drunk and got hit by a car. And so that'll teach Spud from chasing parked cars. Wow, man, this is really cool being at Francisco's, man. Oh, look, Madonna's clothes. Let's burn them. I'm wearing this hat in honor of our drummer, Jim, who's a USC marching Trojan. So, Jim, this is for you. Thank you, and this is Marty Shields, Marty's Corner from Francisco's on Main in La Puente. Happy Halloween. Boo!
Clapping. Thank you. Thank you very much. And again, we'd like to thank Francisco, Frank Sanchez down at Francisco's. He actually allowed us to borrow a lot of the props you see here. Give another hand for Francisco's down in La Puente, huh? Francisco's? Fantastic. And again, on every getting hot out here, I know. On every show, we have to like to have a cultural spotlight, and tonight we're going to have on someone who is going to razzle and dazzle you. She's an incredible dancer. Please, ladies and gentlemen, give a warm welcome to Polynesian dancer Norma Wise. Norma, come on out, Norma. Come on out, Norma. Come on out. Music up in the booth, and let's do it. Music. I hear nothing. I see nothing. There we go.
Kind to you.
cast your cares far out to sea. Am you
Fantastic. That was so graceful. I was just enchanted by the emotions. Now, normally I would think of Polynesian dancers being a lot of walk, 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 walk. Is there actually a name for this kind of dance that you're doing?
This is a hula.
This is strictly a hula. And where did you learn how to do this?
When I was 7, I learned, believe it or not, at the YWCA in Glendale.
But of course, the YWCA in Glendale, yeah. And how long have you been doing this now?
Since I was 7.
Oh! Very astute answering by the hula girl. She knew how to do that. She played right on that real good. I said, we're so glad to have you on the show. And do you actually teach this somewhere? Where do you teach this at?
I teach at Mount San Antonio College.
In Walnut.
Can we hear from Mount San Antonio College? Shut up. Shut up. A great institution. A great institution. I would love to learn how to do this, and I know our beautiful announcer, Lori. So Lori, would you please come up here and join us? Oh, can we hear from Lori, ladies and gentlemen? Now, what exactly do we have to do to learn how to do this? Let me take this jacket off.
I'm going to teach you a different type of a dance. It's from Tahiti.
Uh-huh.
It's an aparima, which is their form of hula. And you're going to do a dance about a little bird who likes deep potato soup. Okay? First of all, you've got to learn to move your hips, because in Hawaii, the hands tell the story, but in Tahiti, the hips tell the whole thing.
Ooh. Okay, I've heard that before.
If you watch,
I've heard that before.
Keep your eyes on the hips.
Oh.
Okay. I'm going to swing them to the right and swing them to the left.
Okay.
Right, the other right. And a left, and a right, and a left. Side, and all the way around.
Can we get the music? Please bring up the music in the studio one more time, and we'll go ahead and have Norma show it. Oh, quiet from the crowd. Too much talking from the peanut gallery. And what else do you have to do now? Okay?
Oh,
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Can we please hear it for Norma? We'll be right back. Don't go away. There's more to come. We have singer-songwriter Stephen Craig. Thank you so much. Thank you, Norma. Thank you so much. Why don't you stay here with us until we actually go out? Let's dance while we're going out. Can we hear for the corner band one time? The corner band. Of course, that's Frank, Al, and Jim in the back, marching trogan. Way to go, Jim. Again, we have Corinne back on the show again, and see how far we've gotten with your assistant. Now, what have you done so far since we last saw you 20 minutes ago?
Well, we've added some shading to enhance her cheekbones, and now we're going to finish her eye makeup to make her eyes look better and do a little dental work.
That really looks starting to look really gruesome. Okay, and when she comes back, what's going to happen the next time she comes here? What's she going to look
like? Well, she'll be just gorgeous. I mean, it'll be just a total remake.
Okay, can we hear it one more time for Corinne? She's going to be leaving us. Hear it one more time. Thank you, Corinne. And this time, we'd like to bring out somebody who was on the show about a month ago, and we had some technical problems, and John, can you go ahead and roll that tape from last time Steve was here? We had some audio problems, so we're going to roll that tape and see what happened, okay? Let's roll that in the studio if we could. Corner, ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to Mr. Stephen Craig. Stephen, take it away.
Yeah, change it. Change it.
Ladies and gentlemen, can you please give a warm welcome to Mr. Stephen Craig? Steve, come on out. He's a good sport. You're a good sport. Okay, here we go.
If you long to see her play, she loves the cloudy moonlight, painted like a poet's dream, it lays upon her face. I love to watch her dancing to the rhythm of the thunder, the beauty of amazing grace. How could it be would think that I could leave her? I give my life, my love, my soul. You just let me come inside. But she said, I don't know. Call me in the morning. Call me in the morning. At the first sign of your shining light. I don't know. Cause you could leave without a warning. Call me in the morning. Just to see if I'm all right. If I'm alright, see if I'm alright. understanding. To my heart she holds the only key. How long till you set me free? I don't know. She said, call me in the morning. Call me in the morning just to see if I'm alright. See if I'm alright. See if I'm alright. Alright, alright.
Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Gregg. Steve, come on up. Thanks for coming back, man. Have a seat, man. Thank you for coming back at such short notice.
No problem.
Now, is this a fashion or is this the grunge look? No, I'm just kidding.
I wouldn't call it grunge.
So what have you been doing since last time we talked to you? How's the band thing coming along?
I'm putting it together still. It's going okay. Kind of slow process. Looking for a good drummer.
Oh, you know hard one. To find.
Yeah, the corner band. I know he's already spoken for.
Oh, you already hit him up. I know
he
did.
About it. It's not gonna happen, I don't think.
And what kind of shows do you got coming up? And last time we talked, you had something going down there by the beach.
Showcasing. I've been doing original showcases in Hollywood. I do a lot of National Academy of Songwriters showcases.
That's right. You tell me something about that.
Right, and I go out there and I get in line and I sing my songs and. You know, and I keep pushing.
Are you doing some studio time? You got something going on right there?
Well, I do a lot of recording at home. I have a home studio.
You have your own studio?
Right, but, you know, it's a lot of money right now. You can send money anywhere.
Send money and care of...
care of Marty Shields.
Send it to me, I'll give it to him.
Right.
Believe me, I'll get it to him.
Yeah. Right on. So, It's a tough business, but it's going good. I'm doing good.
So we're so glad you're back here with us tonight, and we'd like to do one more song for us. So could you please give your warm welcome again to Steve Gregg. Steve, one more time, huh? Fantastic. Well, turn it up, man. Steve Gregg. What song are you going to do for us now, Steve?
This is called The Train Ride.
The Train Ride. This is Steve Craig's Train Ride. Take it away, Steve.
In my town today, there's an old conductor. I thought I heard him say, take the train ride. Just take the train ride with us to the other side. Just take the train ride. Well, I had a few questions about the place that conductor, is there something I should know about the train ride? Yeah, the train ride to the other side. I took the train ride. He said, you are the reason that my train is here today. Can you train ride. Train ride.
Hey, it's about 5 minutes to airtime. Has anybody seen Marty? Man, that guy's getting such a big head. Where is he?
I'm here, Mayor Molto. I always wanted to be big in TV. Join me, Marty Shields, on Marty's Corner, Channel 33 Public Access, Friday at 8 o'clock.
Be there.
If you don't, it's all over.
We're taking off here, and again, it's a great day here at Marty's Corner. We'd like to go ahead and read off a few things that are going on this week. Our calendar of events, let's go through them real quick. We only got a few more minutes. First of all, Francisco's Discount Halloween Shop on locations to serve you everywhere, but the one closest to us is in La Puente, and the phone number is 1-800-47-DRAC, D-R-A-C, DRAC. Isn't that nice? We also have the Poe-a-thon at Mount San Antonio College Friday the 28th. So please go down there. 13 hours of Edgar Allan Poe for your enjoyment.
Oh boy.
Now, there's been some problems with the park and recreation systems. They have no real Halloween things going on for kids this year. But the Pointe Hills Mall is having a trick-or-treat extravaganza. Call your local malls in your area. And we'd like to thank everyone. Oh, before we go out, we'd like to thank Francisco's again for all the decorations. Francisco, thank you. We'd like to thank Tahoe Pumpkins on Valley and Fullerton for our beautiful pumpkins you have here, beautiful pumpkins. And of course, always Pizza Hut in Hacienda Heights, the official caterer of Marty's Corner. We'd like to thank the audience. Can the audience do it one more time for the audience? Clap, hey! The Corner Band, we're out of here. Have a good night. See you in about a month or so. Take it away, guys. And the kids. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, come on in. Oh, I'm sorry, Corinne. I almost forgot Corinne. Oh, I'm so sorry. I got caught up in the moment. Ooh, I'm gonna come up here. Let's look in this camera.
Oh. Hey, Marty, it's my first wife.
Oh, be quiet. Now, Corinne, this can be done in just an hour. And what is your phone number over there? And why don't you give us the phone number real quick?
It's 818-303-7053.
Okay. And if you want to be interested, you want to get into this kind of field, give her a call. Does she look incredible, ladies and gentlemen? Just in an hour, I'm going to hear from all of them. Again, like I said, we're out of here. See you next time on Marty's Corner Band. Take it away. Thank you so much.